and load it in the shortened position. I always recommend this is not a pre-exhaust, this is a pre-activate.
What's up? 筋肉ハヤトです。さあ今日は筋肉がつきやすくなる筋トレのルーティンの決め方見ていきましょう。筋トレの順番、ルーティンはどう決めていますか？順番によって筋肉がつきやすくなったり、逆にもったいないことをしてしまっている場合があります。そんなことをベンさんの MY40 ジムからジョーさんが話してくれています。どんなことに気をつければいいのでしょうか？早速見ていきましょう。どうぞ。
Hey guys, Coach Joe Bennett coming at you from MY40 Gym. Gonna talk about how do you design an optimal workout. Obviously dependent on, you know, where your nutrients at, where your recovery is at, where your training phase is that day, there's a little bit of variability. But if it's just like we had to design, hey, all things being the same, what's a solid workout? Here's a good place to start. One, always do something to activate first. Sometimes this can be a motion, sometimes it can actually be an exercise. But pick whatever muscle group you're going to train and load it in the shortened position. I always recommend this is not a pre-exhaust, this is a pre-activate. So of all of your exercises, you shouldn't be taking this to complete muscular failure. The goal should be just to squeeze that muscle as hard as you can with a relatively light to moderate load, just so you can actually feel the muscle, in which case, one, you'll get more power output from the rest of your workout, and you'll feel that muscle better for the rest of the workout as well too. The second exercise I would then go to is basically going to be your biggest move it. So something that's going to be more central nervous system taxing. So again, if it's going to be legs, it'll be a squat, it'll be a leg press. If it's chest, it's going to be a push or a press. You know, if it's back, it's going to be a row. It's going to be something that generally involves multiple joints and the thing you're going to handle your heaviest load on. So it doesn't really have a specific goal of shortened, lengthened. It's something that's going to work in the mid-range. Just kind of think your big movements. From there, you really have the option. If we've already done shortened, we've already done mid-range, from there you want to go to lengthened position. So we've kind of taxed, again, the shortened, we've taxed the mid-range. Now we want to tax all those fibers to the fully lengthened position. One, we've got strength left there, so we want to train that range. But two, once you've kind of already got a lot of blood flow going, you've got a pump, you can continue to tax those muscles and muscle cells further by putting them under more strain and stress in the lengthened position. Then really to finish the workout, this is kind of where you have like, kind of just have fun. Just kind of do the thing that you want to do where it's really just trying to get output, the last little bit that you can out of it. So this is a great place for a superset, for a tri-set, for a giant set, for something that's just going to tax every last little bit of metabolic capacity that that muscle still has. So again, if you're going to do some fun stuff with strip sets, drop sets, supersets, this is probably the time and place to do it. Again, this is Joe Bennett. Till I see you guys next time.
さあ、いかがでしたでしょうか。筋肉を縮めてアクチベーションを行う、筋肉の中間位置で高重量を行う、ストレッチ重視で全可動域で行う、この流れが一番筋肉を全体的に追い込むことができるとのことでした。確かにトレーニング後半では細かいコントロールがしづらくなるし、トレーニング後半で高重量を扱うことは難しくなってきますよね。こういったガイドラインがあることによってルーティンが決めやすくなりそうですね。みんなはどんな順番で筋トレを選択していますか？コメント欄で教えてください。僕はほとんどこの順番だったんですが、3つ目だけストレッチではなくパンプ重視でした。この順番も取り入れてみます。最後まで見ていただいてありがとうございます。ここでみんなに質問です。もし僕が実際に海外に行ったらどんな企画、どんなものが見たいですか？コメント欄で教えてください。感想や動画のリクエスト、チャンネル登録お待ちしてます。ではまた。